for a month, you know, to see his parents. Unbelievable. If he knew that this is going to happen,
I'm pretty sure. So you haven't called them yet?
I haven't called them yet. I don't know.
What are you going to say when you do?
I don't know what I'm going to say. It's going to be so hard and emotional. I mean, I know how they're going to react. They're going to be heartbroken, you know, big time. Because they were supposed to see him, like, today. He was supposed to be home. If he decided to go, he was supposed to be home, you know. But
the FBI agents, did they say where they were from? I mean, I'm assuming Orlando and Tampa, yes. But I was told one was from Boston.
Three was from Boston. Okay, yesterday, actually, here's a guy named Chris. FBI agent, right? He was contacting with Ibrahim from the beginning, and he always like used to make up some meetings with him, like to see him and stuff. And he's the one who's working here, Orlando, right? And he called yesterday, said guys from the Boston want to see you. Like this is the last meeting that you want to talk to him and close the case, throw it away. Let's do it. And he didn't want to do it. In the beginning, he didn't want to do it. He had a bad feeling. I can understand him too. You know what I'm saying? And I said, all right, if you don't want to do it, don't do it. But if you don't do it, they're not gonna leave you alone. They're gonna go. You're gonna get more suspicious. And so he decided to go. And they want me to go with him, and I went there. We went there, and there's this guy, Chris, and three other guys. You know what I mean? They were in suits and stuff. And he told me, Chris told me that they came in the morning from Chicago. It was three FBI agents. They came from Chicago. It was like special, I don't know, mission, something like that. So I thought, all right, it's pretty serious. So.